acceptance of Abdullah ibn Umar when his son died, and he was laughing. And he said, you know, how could you be laughing on the day where you, when your son died? And he had shown before a distress over the sickness of his son. He told them that that distress was out of mercy for his son because he's suffering. And then when Allah decreed for him to die, قَدْ أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ أَمْرًا فَأَحْبَبْتُ أَنْ أُحِبَّ مَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ. Allah loved the certain or liked something, so I liked to like what he liked. I liked to like what he liked. So Allah liked to take his son back. So he showed acceptance of that, and he liked the decree of Allah. The loss of a son is certainly the greatest affliction that you could someone could endure in the dunya, of the dunya afflictions. But he showed that acceptance and contentment with that decree to show that he likes whatever Allah likes. Now, how come he did this when the Prophet ﷺ wept over the death of Ibrahim? So the scholars have different ways of reflecting on this. But one of the most beautiful explanations is Ibn al-Qayyim's explanation that, you have two different stations or maqam. Maqam al-Rida or maqam al-Rahma. You have two different qualities that you want to exhibit as a human being, or two different stations that you want to hold on during a time like this. Then the station of rida, acceptance, contentment with Allah's decrees, and the station of rahmah, or showing mercy. So he said that the Prophet was perfectly able to manage both at the same time. Abdullah ibn Umar was not. So he chose the maqam of acceptance because he was not able to basically straddle the two maqamat or the two stations at the same time.